Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, my dearest respected brothers and sisters. A few days ago, a parent contacted me from our Maktoom Madrasah, which is a special educational needs provision, and said to me that my son has made a model of the Quwwatul Islam Masjid and he wishes to visit the masjid if it's possible. So I discussed this with a colleague and we made the provision. Within a matter of seconds entering into the masjid, he started running frantically like I've never seen anyone do before. He climbed on top of the minbar, started giving a sermon, sat on the imam's chair and ran around as though it was a playground. And I started to think to myself that, Ya Allah, today we are making sure that we don't engage in social gatherings. We make sure that we don't leave our homes. We don't enter the masjid.
Whereas unfortunately, for many families who look after special needs children, this is just the norm for them. Avoiding social gatherings such as weddings. Change of routine. Today we are complaining we can't go to the gym. Our routine has changed. Again, this is just normal. Self-isolation. Many children feel the safest place for them is the home. And unfortunately, many of these children cannot attend the masjid on a normal day.
So let us take a second or two during this month of Ramadan, before the time of iftar, to make dua for these countless heroes. Because these heroes aren't just heroes during the time of pandemic, they are heroes for the whole life. Because they're having to look after children who unfortunately are in isolation for much part of their life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless these carers, the parents, the mums and dads, the volunteers who look after the children who have disabilities or learning difficulties. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all the volunteers who try and assist in trying to relieve some pressure from these families. Jazakum Allahu khairan, ahsanul jazah.